Welcome back to our case, where we continue to follow Brian's story. Brian had been involved in a motor vehicle accident a year earlier. An X-ray revealed that he had fractured the right humerus, and this was fixed surgically. A day later, he complained of abdominal pain, and a CT scan showed that he had sustained an injury to his spleen. Later that day, his blood pressure dropped dramatically in keeping with the delayed rupture of the spleen. Back in the ward, he started to spike fevers, and blood cultures grew the bacteria Streptococcus pyogenes, showing that he had had an infection. Let's go back again to hear from Sally, the general surgeon at the hospital, who was looking after Brian.
We suspected that Brian was brewing some mischief in his abdomen to cause the fever post-splenectomy. Sephrenic collections can develop after splenectomy and can become infected. To check this out, we arranged for him to have an abdominal ultrasound. Let's see if the ultrasonographer has found anything. Okay, so the ultrasound shows that Brian has a cystic fluid collection in keeping with a left sephrenic abscess. This may be a cause of his fever and will need to be drained. We'll try antibiotics and percutaneous drainage under ultrasound guidance first. Hopefully Brian will avoid another trip to the operating theatre this time.